Folks, welcome back to Inspirational Waves Indie Rock Radio with your host Will
and Jen.
And today we're going to go over Jen's book, Roots Return Homesteading Bible. And today we're going to work on chapter number 3.
Returning to your roots.
Yes. Take it away, Jennifer.
Right. Well, last time, guys, if you hadn't listened to chapter 2, we talked about development a little bit and transformation of yourself. So that was part of it. So if you didn't listen to that, go ahead and take a listen. We're on a lot of different platforms. Will, you're best at this.
Yeah, so of course we're on Podbean, Audible, iHeartRadio, YouTube, and Spotify. But if you want to make it really easy for yourself, just go to theranchhub.com. Theranchhub.com. You can find everything right there. And also, we've got something new for you guys. We've got the Ranch Hub 103.9 FM internet radio.
Woo-hoo.
So check us out.
Yeah. Yes. The best raw talk and indie rock.
That's right.
So back to chapter 3, though. This is a good chapter just to kind of take you back to your childhood and kind of remind you of the things that you did that surprised yourself when you were young. And now you're going back to that. You're re-inspiring yourself.
Yeah, I need to re-inspire myself.
I need to re-inspire myself. So the verse I chose was in Genesis 19, 26, in the Interlinear Bible, page 15. But his wife looked back from behind him, and she became a pillar of salt.
That's right. And it's not the Himalayan salt that you can use on your steaks.
No.
I don't know what kind of salt
well,
that was.
Oh, there was, but
I wouldn't want to eat that, I don't think. That's
don't
pretty
know.
Gross.
So when I talked about that in returning to your roots, I was just kind of thinking of like the wheel, right? It's this movement. Now, if you know me at all, I have this side where I can really get into stuff, and it can be very boring. So if you want to pass on by, go ahead.
No, don't. You better not.
But
you better not touch that dial.
But I like details. And I mean, I can spend hours and hours digging. Have you ever seen those videos of those YouTube videos where people are watching someone like for hours dig or smooth something out or make a piece of pottery or dig out a piece of wood or carve or paint? I
yeah.
like those.
I remember watching those guys that they make those, they dig in the ground and they make the different like forts and
oh yes,
things.
I love those.
Like,
I don't know, there's all kinds of them.
Primitive,
yeah,
primitive whatever, engineer,
yes.
designer.
I love that. And they'll yeah. make like little beds and little fire pits and places yeah. for like, and they make their own like utensils sometimes.
And then they'll
fires.
Take like bamboo and they hook it all up
yeah.
to the stream down the way, and it kind of gives them some water and everything.
Yeah.
They make these beautiful like primitive pools and those sort of things.
So amazing.
One guy, he's just taking like a bath in his pool. I don't know. Like, I don't know.
It's awesome.
It's a trip. Yeah. Primitive. It's very primitive.
But that is what I'm talking about today. It's kind of an in-depth talk, guys. So I just want to kind of let you remember that way back in the Bible times, right? Lot, she had a hard time letting go of material possessions and things of this earth. And that's hard, you know, sometimes. A lot of times people, they get really, really wrapped up in things. And things meaning stuff.
It's all
right?
about the cash, yo.
Yeah. And it's really sad. Like it really, or they become greedy, or they become selfish, or narcissistic, or, you know, completely wrapped up in their own thoughts and ideas.
Yeah, I mean, I remember telling you a bunch of times where when I first started in movie, television, whatever industry, fighting, stunt work, I didn't get paid very much money, but yet a lot of my friends and relatives would always ask me, how much you get paid for that? How much? Almost like to diminish the work, even though I really didn't get paid hardly anything, and sometimes actually nothing.
Right.
But, I mean, it was still important to me. But, yeah, people
right.
get wrapped up in materialism big time, you know.
Yeah, yeah. And sometimes you're missing out on that experience, or you're missing out on connection with people. So, as I'm talking about this, I'm going to be talking about returning to your roots isn't easy because you got to dig within yourself, okay, deeply, right? Literally, figuratively, it's I know I'm saying it really light and fluffy right now, but you really, really, I think it's a time right now where we have to really dig deep. I think about that toothed wheel or like a gear, like each tooth supports the progression of that next tooth, right? So when that gear is moving a little bit, the other gears that are next to it are also moving, and some are moving in opposite directions, some are moving in the same direction.
I'm thinking of like a watch.
Yeah, yeah, or a big clock or something, yeah. Yes. I always think of that movie Titanic.
Oh, really?
Where, yeah.
I mean, I don't know why. Troy only yeah. wants that thing played like all day long, and he makes Lego Titanics and whatever all day.
Yes, all day long. So he loves this Titanic and all the music that goes with that, and it is pretty dark, but I don't know, he just likes it, like he just enjoys it. And so this thought process of this gears, right, and Titanic, remember in the movie, if you've seen the movie, and they are waiting for these, they're putting out all the orders, turn the, you know, and it takes like, you know, a decade for them to get all the way back to the people in the engine room to switch the gears. Oh, they got to flip this switch and pass this over and turn this wheel and click this switch and that, and everybody's moving, and you know, and they got to shovel coal in to get, I mean, they're all moving. They're moving so fast to try to get this. Yes. Just to do one thing. And the one thing is they have to literally stop everything from going in one direction, stop, and then change to the other direction.
Oh, that can right? be very difficult, it sounds like.
It's
Jennifer.
Not like just pushing on a brake of your vehicle, right? You push on your brake, you turn it from drive to reverse, and you go in reverse. Easy, 2-second process. But what's going on under the engine, that's a lot.
Yeah.
Right? All in that transmission. You got all those gears. If you've ever seen a transmission, and I have, by the way, anyway, this is a long time ago, it's complex. You can't just start messing with the gears and everything that's in a transmission, or you are in big trouble.
Yeah,
big
that's true.
Trouble. So just to let you know, that is kind of where we're at right now in life, I believe.
We're a transmission?
We are in a transition.
Transition. Transmission's in a transition right here in life.
We got a lot of cheese going on.
Yeah, there we go.
So yes, it's right. We have to slow down to a near stop, and we can't look back. Okay, that's the thing. We can't stop and then just stay stopped. Okay? It's kind of like driving down the highway, right? We're going down the highway, and we are looking in our rear view mirror the whole time. What's going to end up happening, Will, when we do this? We're going to crash.
We're going to crash. You know, it's like if you're racing and you're always looking in your rearview mirror when you're leading the race. You know, you're driving in the mirror. Next thing you know, you're getting passed up.
Yeah, driving along.
Because you get so nerved up and everything. You're watching that car. You see if it's going to pass you on the left, the right. Is it going to do with a bump and run? What is it going to do? Next thing you know, you're done.
Here comes the meat wagon.
Whatever. You got the meat wagon. We're talking about a race. Not something else. I don't know what you're saying.
If anybody knows and has seen Tommy Boy, they know exactly what I'm talking about.
I seen Tommy Boy. I just don't remember.
He goes, wee. Here comes the meat wagon.
You had an espresso today. Just admit that to everyone.
Oh, yes. Okay, so Will took me out. I got the most magnificent espresso. It wasn't. Oh, I got an extra shot of espresso for free.
Thank you. It was so nice. Oh, yeah. It was a freebie right there. Here's an extra shot of espresso.
You guys missed it. You should have seen Will's eyes. The roll of the eyes.
Well, see, you know, we're at the grocery store, you know, so she gets jacked up on coffee. And now we're going to run around the grocery store and get 10 items of this and 5 of that and 6 of this. And five. It's like, oh, my gosh. I just wanted to go in there and spend like about about 30, 40 bucks.
Yeah, he's like mission oriented. Like, go
like
here.
$100
Go over here. We go. Doesn't everybody
buy this and that and this and that? And
doesn't everybody spend $100 every time they go to the grocery store? That's my question.
No.
Yes, I think
I'll
so.
Give
come
you
on.
The straight
come on,
answer,
Gable.
No.
Yes. Okay, maybe not. But I know that it's seemingly very difficult not to get like the things that you think you're going to need for a time, maybe a week or two, and you end up spending like $100 every time.
Nope.
Well, maybe not.
Unless
for
I'm going to buy a whole bunch of stuff, you know, for the week.
Right.
But anyway, actually, Jenny does a lot better than me. I just buy one of everything and I run out the next day.
And then he has to go back the next day, which is all gas money, time.
Yeah, she usually gets about three or four things of an item. That way we don't run out. So she does a lot better as far as that goes.
See?
Yeah.
I was thinking ahead. I was prepared. Okay, so we're moving on, right? And we're talking, I want to tell you guys about a story. And yes, am I getting to any major points? Am I just nailing it out for you? No, but let me remind you that my whole point today, I said, was a long, drawn-out digging. We're digging, or we're making pottery, or we're painting a picture. And so we have to watch, and we have to listen as this painting becomes visual so we can see it.
Okay, Bob
right?
Ross.
Okay, Bob Ross. I would love to have a nice blonde afro and some kind of tall.
She said that
aquarium
before. Trust
heels.
Me, she has this
and
in
disco.
Her mind.
Disco.
Disco. Yeah.
Yeah.
Weird stuff with afro wigs and stuff. What's going on?
Bell bottoms.
Right.
Come on.
And platform
Come
shoes.
Come on. Oh, it's a lot of fun.
Is this in your book, by any chance?
No,
what we're
no,
talking
it's not
about?
In my book at all.
Okay.
Not even close. No, it's not. But it is fun. That's what I have to say. Who doesn't love that disco? Disco balls. Ooh, and glitter.
We're ready for the book.
Okay, so I decided to start. Okay, talking about, now, I way in the back pasture, we have this tractor that died. And this, I have to kind of take you back, but at one point, with a property, having a tractor, not being able to know how to run this thing, if it broke. I didn't, at one point, I didn't even know how to start it. But once I got to start it, that doesn't mean that you know how to fix everything, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
You buy a new tractor.
Trust me, we learned that lesson today.
And then you got to maintain your equipment. You got to know how to fix all your stuff. So not, and I, you know what really irks me? You got to fix things to fix things. Like, you're trying to fix your yard, you're trying to clean it up, you're trying to make it look good or whatever, and then your tractor busts. So you got to fix your tractor so that you can fix your yard.
You mean like I mowed 3/4 of the yard and I can't mow the rest of it because I got a fuse that keeps blowing every time I start the tractor?
Precisely.
Yeah.
And how problematic was that for you?
It's more than problematic. If I think about it, I get anxiety.
Because why? Because your whole goal for the day was to complete a task,
yeah,
right?
Exactly.
Complete a task. But you couldn't because why?
I got a monkey wrench thrown into my plans.
Exactly. And that's what happens.
A stick in my spokes.
Most of the time when homesteading, when working on a farm, when working on a ranch, when doing something that's hard, you know, you get a stick in your spoke.
Every time.
It's difficult. And so that's why I'm telling you right now, when those times happen, go back. Don't expect somebody else to come and save you and rescue you. Think back to a point in your life. What there has to be a point in everyone's life where, and remember, this is Inspirational Radio. And so you can be a negative person on this.
Negative Nelly?
Or a negative Nick?
Whatever.
You can be negative if you want to on this, but we challenge you to think back, inspiring yourself in positivity, to think back about a time in your life where you surprised yourself with your ability, your talent. Something you did that you were like, man, I nailed that. Yes, I did something so awesome. I'm proud of my whatever. the job I did.
Oh, you're talking about some time back in my life when I gave myself like a self high five?
Yes, or pat on the back, right? You're proud of your a self high five. Yeah, that's a good visual. So yes, something like that, right? So I got to kind of read this because this is part of the story where I kind of want to draw you in a little bit to kind of get the feeling. How does that sound?
Go for it.
Okay, so I decided to start the tractor again, making sure I did. Okay, so wait, let me go back. I'm a little too far. I drove my truck back out to the dead tractor. I turned on the portable generator. I plugged the battery charger into the generator. I lifted the tractor seat. I connected the cables. The charger showed that the battery was fine and nearly fully charged. Okay, so it wasn't the battery? I decided to start the tractor again, making sure I did everything correctly this time. So as I was running through the steps in my head and saw the emergency brake was on, so I promptly released it, and then I pulled out the choke. I turned up the speed accelerator to high, and I made sure to push in the clutch all the way. And then I turned the key. Yes! Success! The tractor started right up. I had done it. So it was simply the emergency brake causing the problems. But the point is, I surprised myself with my ability, and I didn't know I had. And it was always there, I just didn't know it. And that's, my friends, is where it takes us to the essence of the roots return. Because by digging deep within yourself and believing in the skills and knowledge that's been there naturally all along, or that you prayed to God for wisdom and strength you needed, then through His grace, He steps in and He helps you and He gives you strength, wisdom, the gifts, the courage you asked Him for. You came through and were able to do what was needed, and it took you changing gears and believing in yourself and the power God has planted inside of you who believe to accomplish what He has purposed for you. We were all made by Yahweh, and He has given us an internal ability to communicate with Him. We were made in His image, each with different and unique abilities. But all of us can communicate with our Father, Christ Jesus, because He also designed us this way. It is part of our birthright, which is also a title of a really good book, by the way, I'd recommend, by Timothy Alberino. When you dig deep and find your soul, you can become tougher and more persistent. So are you tapping into this closest moments with God and sharing a close, intimate time with your Maker? I dare state that's precisely what's happening in our times of need. We are going back to where we were made, as well as to the One who made us. So returning to your roots doesn't mean holding onto all your possessions and dragging them with you and your past baggage, right? Sometimes moving on to living life in the present requires turning away from the past and simply not looking back.
So it's okay to turn away, just don't look back.
Often,
or assault.
When we are seeking and working purposely with our hands, Elohim will bless us and give us a passion or gifts for His calling, which is a much bigger than ourselves and far more important than we can imagine. Those things left behind must stay in our past, because moving on into the living and present requires turning away from those things.
Are you sick of those brown coffee-stained teeth? Are you tired of your pineal gland being calcified? Well, be sick and tired no longer, folks. Get Jen's fluoride-free toothpaste. It comes in cool peppermint flavor. It'll freshen your breath. It'll whiten your teeth. And it's all natural. Go to theranchhub.com and press the Etsy button. It'll take you right there to Jen's store, and you can pick up yours today. And don't forget, your purchases help support the show. And we appreciate you. Next up, we got some amazing indie rock for you from the Chimps with What Are We Fighting For? Right here on Inspirational Waves.
I've been living my life in soul.
And now back to our interview with Jennifer Kraft, author of Roots Return Homesteading Bible.
Those things left behind must stay in our past, because moving on into the living and present requires turning away from those things we may have thought were so important. But God will provide a new, more prosperous plan and purpose, because He's a jealous God and He wants us to return to Him. And we are called according to His purpose. That reminds me of the scriptures of Lot's wife. We are called to be the salt of the earth.
Not turn into the salt.
Matthew 5:13. You are the salt of the earth. Very good.
But a different sort of salt, right? I mean, good to be the salt of the earth, but not to be the salt that's a pillar on the earth.
Yes.
Don't become... Be the salt, but don't be the salt, sort of.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, in the book, this is a really good reference from The Return of the Puritans by Pat Brooks, a fifth edition, and page 176. Love that book, by the way. It's called Return of the Puritans by Pat Brooks. One more time. Sorry about that. Okay, so for those who spurn, here's a quote from it. For those who spurn the call of the Lord to be salt. Poor Miss Lot, she loved her pretty clothes and her lovely home, and she had never had time to be salt for God while she lived in Sodom. Just too busy. Guess she never dreamed the hold things had on her because they pulled her back like her lifetime of taking God's word lightly. Can you imagine her thoughts in a split second before judgment? Surely God can't mean He'll destroy all my nice friends. Why, a loving God could not damn anyone. Then she turned and became exactly what she failed to be during her earthly life, salt. Remember Lot's wife?
Yeah, so Sodom and Gomorrah, those were some interesting towns, cities, or whatever.
Yes.
They were actually... well-to-do places. People were having a lot of success there. They had nice things. They were living a pretty extravagant lifestyle.
Yeah.
And I think, I mean, at the end of the day, you could almost call them both progressive cities.
Yes, right.
So there you go. Look how they progressed.
Beautiful. Yeah, they progressed.
So yeah,
all
next
right.
time you want to call yourself a progressive city, you might want to think of Sodom and Gomorrah
and think of what happened to those areas.
Exactly.
There. So again, with this, it's really important you take yourself into a new arena, so to speak. You want to train versus try. Now, a lot of times you have to transform this, right? You have to sort of, well, let me just say this. Trying never achieves consistent results. Right?
Right. I mean, you have to attempt something, right? But you need to be disciplined enough to follow through and to,
yes,
to move on into, you know.
Right. Trying is an attempt. I'm sorry. Wipe my nose there. Trying is an attempt to change our lifestyle, but it comes with very little commitment. And yeah. that's the thing, right?
Yeah, you got to commit to something, and like I said, have the discipline to keep it. You know, you have to keep going.
Yes.
Right, and not just like try. You know, I tried this, and I just give up. You know, and
right.
expect some sort of miraculous result.
Yeah, you have to kind of be flexible with what happens as you're going along this road of commitment and training. You have to commit. You can't just say, "Well, I'm going to try this today." That's not a commitment. That's not going to get you anywhere. You know, I'm gonna try to run a lap today.
Well, Jennifer actually did a really good job, because I had kind of slacked a little bit as far as putting this show together. And Jennifer was like, she just walks in the room and, "Hey, I'm going to do a radio show today." Okay. You know, then I set up the equipment and everything. And that's just the kind of little prod that I needed to get rolling. But she had the discipline to stick with it, and she knew that we needed to tape a show, and boom, she was in here getting
ready.
Well,
I felt like somebody needs to hear this today.
Yeah,
and
we all do.
And yes, and so I was like, I was prompted to do it because I was like, because at first I was like, this is literally what I thought was going through my head. I was like, chapter 3 wasn't that interesting for me. And I kind of have little, like, little talks with God throughout the day. I'll be like, you know, oh, look at the, you know, I'll say, I love that little cardinal outside or something. But I also have these little things where I'm like, you know, we really need to do our radio show. I love it. I really love our radio show, guys. But, you know, it's something you have to take time out and do. And I was like, I don't know, but I just felt like I needed to today. And that I got that prompting. Yeah. Somebody needs to hear this.
Yeah.
Somebody needs to hear it. And so.
Well, I mean, that's something that I actually want to talk about just really quickly for a second here, is that when it comes to speaking to God, to Yahweh, there's a lot of ways to do it, but I feel like Jennifer's more conversational with God, and I'm more like prayerful. You know, my approach is just pray, and I'd like to probably be more conversational like Jennifer. You know, because I feel like that's more relationship. You know what I mean? Relationship mm-hmm. stuff. You know.
I think however anybody does it, like, I just think that God just absolutely loves our attention. Doesn't matter what it is. Like, it truly doesn't matter.
He literally made all the stuff.
Yeah.
Like, we're here.
Everything, when you walk outside, guys, everything is still His creation. And we're His creation as long as we don't that up.
Yeah, we're made in His image. So that's even, you know, more important. It's more, you know, amazing.
Yeah. And so I think y'all are awesome. First of all, we love you guys. You are loved. You are cared about. And we hope so much that you enjoyed this today, because it's from our hearts. It's heartfelt from the ranch hub, ranch hub.
You know, a lot of things we do for you guys. You know, we try to bring this information to you, try to bless your life with it, and we do our best, you know, at putting these shows together. So, I mean, if you guys have any questions for us, don't forget, go ahead and hit us up. You can, if you're listening to this on YouTube, which is actually, you're watching it, but you're listening to it.
Right.
Go ahead and make a comment down below. Yeah. If you're watching it or listening to this on another platform, go ahead and hit us up. Go to theranchhub.com and you can see our contact information on there. You could subscribe to the website. That way you could get really cool stuff like Jenny's blog and maybe some recipes and things like that. But just let us know what you guys think about this sort of thing, because we enjoy creating this show for you. And if it blesses you, you know, that's a bonus.
Well, and another thing is that the YouTube channel for our indie rock, right, our Inspirational Waves indie rock radio show is brand new. We only have like 100 subscribers on that channel because it's so new. So we only have what? This will be our third show. So we are very new. So we would love it if y'all jumped on board and supported that channel as well, because we are going to keep expanding. Have we talked about the next project that we're wanting to do?
Before Jennifer spills the beans on our next project, let's get into some great indie rock. How about North of Never with The River, right here on Inspirational Waves Indie Rock Radio. Found yourself just aimlessly scrolling past YouTube channels, can't find nothing to watch, can't find nothing that interests you, can't find nothing that you could put on and like your whole family could listen to? Well, look no further. Go to theranchhub.com, scroll down, and check out our link to The Ranch Network. It's our YouTube channel. The Ranch Network is about sustainability, survival, preparedness, farming, building, and growing organically. We purpose to connect people from across the earth and create thriving communities where we can share hope and inspire positive changes in our lifestyles. Go to theranchhub.com and click on our link for The Ranch Network. Don't forget, please subscribe to the channel once you're there, comment, share our videos. We appreciate you. Now back to the interview with author Jennifer Kraft of Roots Return Homesteading Bible.
Well, the next project, guys, we're super excited about. Like, we want to start building a tiny home. And
homes. But we'll start with one.
Well, yeah, that's what I always say. You just said what I always say, and I just said what you say.
But here's the thing that I had a little bit of difficulty with. So there's so many projects that can be done here on the ranch. Because we got so much going on, whether it be planting or fixing or making new things, whatever. But my goal was to eventually start making some tiny homes and then sell them and generate money enough to maybe make more tiny homes, maybe get some land, you know, for investment type purposes and whatever. Right. But what happens is, like I said, there's so many things that can be done around here. Sometimes you get sidetracked.
Yes.
You know, And there's somebody that's sitting across from me right now that has a lot of great ideas that I get involved in their shenanigans and go down their rabbit holes, their shenanigans, and I go down their rabbit holes with them.
Yay!
And next thing I know, I'm off in the field looking at flowers or
it's
something.
It's wonderful.
So, but I think we're going to get back to, you know, Jennifer's actually came around. She's like, you know, maybe we should just start devoting a lot of our energy and whatnot into building a tiny home. I'm like,
yeah.
Oh my gosh, she's finally coming around. This is great.
So yeah, so that, well, you have to realize I wanted that a long, long, I'm talking about maybe like 10 years ago, I was like, I really want to build tiny homes. And that dream just kind of went
down
the proverbial toilet.
You know, back full circle, and we're going to do this thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so that dream died. I mean, until...
Now it's been resurrected.
It's sort of the return of the tiny home.
Return to your roots.
Yeah. Yes.
But yeah, it's really cool, though, how we actually come together on a lot of these ideas and projects and all this kind of stuff. Because, you know, we're together quite a bit. I think we're together quite a bit compared to most couples, really. In the next few months, years, and whatever, it's probably going to be a whole lot more even. But that's okay because we love each other and we like being around each other. It's a blessing to us, right?
Yes.
But, yeah, we're going to be working on some tiny homes and everything. And I'm glad that we're like on the same sheet of music. And we're on the same sheet of music a lot of times anyway. But this is one that I really am happy about, that we're going to go full force on it and get some work done.
I know, I'm very excited. Like, I don't know if y'all know, but I've always been into that when it, like, home interiors and design, and it's kind of something of a passion.
Tell people about that app that you have on your phone that
you
play.
Yeah, the design app.
You played that ever since I met you. Tell them about that.
I do. I play this design app, like, every day, and I play it for free. You can spend boatloads of money.
Do you know the name
and
of
you
it
can
or
actually
no?
design.
Design. That's the
design
name of design. Okay.
Yeah. Design. It's called here. I'll look at
it's
it.
Actually called
but
design.
It's literally called design.
So she goes on there and it gives her. Does it give you?
Oh,
like,
it's called Design Home.
Design Home.
Design Home.
Does it give you like a budget and then you pick different things that you can?
You
put
have
into
a budget
room?
And you can like watch. I do everything for free, but obviously you could get. You could spend tons of money on this one. Because you can actually buy the furniture. And I've seen many people buy. I look at a lot of these shows on TV, like the different design ones. And the same furniture that I saw on my design game is they have. And they like refurbish somebody's home.
That's wild.
Or whatever with it.
Yeah.
So you can also buy. See, so like I could buy the Moonlit Orchard collection for $299. But I never buy any that I click off of it. And I just do the, it's called the live challenges. There's challenges and then your home.
And then people, what they do, they look at what you just designed.
And
then
they vote on it.
They vote on it.
And you get dollars and diamonds for,
ooh, some
for your,
diamonds.
Yeah,
there
so
we go.
I usually only have like between maybe $2,000 or $5,000, and then I have about 500 to 1,000 diamonds usually.
But you get some pretty good votes, don't you? People like your stuff. They like your
I
designs.
I have done pretty good for free.
Yeah.
If I paid, like I'm at a 4.33 stars right now and level 30, but there's like a bajillion, there's not a bajillion, but like people are on level 178.
Good
and
gosh,
I mean,
take this stuff seriously.
Yes.
I mean, who's
I'm on level 30.
That?
I'm on level 30. It took me a really long time to do
was
that.
Like,
you said I've been doing
it
forever,
like
and I'm only up.
So like Chip and Joanna Gaines, are they on like 175 or
it's
something like that?
It's just really cool because you get, okay, I don't know, but what's really cool about it is you get to learn the different styles of things. So I will know by looking at a piece of furniture, whether it's contemporary, whether it's luxe, whether it's modern or, you know, farmhouse or the different styles. And I can easily match things up that go really well together, even if on my budget, even on a lower budget without spending a whole bunch of money to get really fancy, expensive furnishings.
Now, okay, this is going to be a kind of a strange question, but do you think with that experience, it's just an app, it's just a game on your phone, do you think that's actually prepared you for designing interiors and things like that? In a way?
In a way, a small way. But I would say, okay, so I kind of come by it naturally in a way because my grandma, she was a designer.
She was? What was her name? What was your grandma's name?
Alma.
Okay.
And she used to work at DeWards. This is in Michigan. Mm-hmm. But she used to work at DeWards, and this is a drapery place. And she used to, yeah, it was a real fancy, dancy place. And she would kind of do a lot of that. And she was great at sewing. Like, she taught me how to sew. Like, when I was really young, I made a skirt. And I had to sew, like, elastic around it, which is kind of hard, you know, because you have to have this tension just right to do it. And it has to be the right length, and obviously not. Well, and then you have to model it. And then when you modeled it, you get it, they give you, like, an award or whatever if you do really well. So I got one of those. I don't even.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah, I got a special ribbon or best of show or some baloney. I'm sure it wasn't, you know.
I got to say, too, that when we first met, you modified a pair of my pants and made them into shorts and sewn them up. And they look like shorts, like they never were, like long pants. They look perfect.
Yeah.
Like, wonderful.
Oh, well, all the curtains. I don't know if you do that. But
you sewed all the curtains together?
I sewed all the curtains.
No way.
To fit. Yeah.
Wow.
And so, but the, you know, grandma. So, like, yeah, I don't know. I have a knack for not really hard sewing. Like, I always thought it'd be neat to sew swimsuits. I love swimwear. I totally love swimwear.
Hey, and according to your mom, make sure you only get German swimwear.
I can't wear like anything really crappy. Like, a lot of times I don't really care. I'll just pick up a swimsuit. Like, I think the last time I went to Target and bought a swimsuit, yeah. I was like...
Before we talk about Jenny's mom, we need to talk about theranchhub.com, a place where you can scroll down, click on Jenny's Etsy store, and you're going to find a couple things that you would never think would be on there. Jenny is actually really good at formulating colognes and perfumes. She's got Songbird Summer for women and Blackwood for men. Blackwood cologne has a natural black walnut base, and the Songbird Summer has purple sweet potato juice from purple sweet potatoes grown right here on the ranch. It's crazy, but both of these fragrances are mild. They don't just punch in the face. They smell good. It's something that you'll get excited about. If your lady's wearing the Songbird Summer, you're gonna get excited. If you're a guy, if your guy's wearing Blackwood cologne, ladies, you're going to get really excited about his cologne. So check them out. They're made with 100% pure and natural essential oils, specially formulated by Professor Jenny. And I'm telling you what, they are amazing. Check them out. TheRanchHub.com. Scroll down to the Etsy button. Click it and buy some for yourself or get some for your favorite person as a gift. Get yours today. I'll tell you what. Nothing gets me more happier than some great indie rock. How about some River Brooks? It Ain't Right, right here on Inspirational Waves Indie Rock Radio.
Yeah.
Now back to our interview with author Jennifer Kraft of Roots Return Homesteading Bible.
I can't believe you wear swimsuits like that. You need to wear good swimsuits, quality material.
I'm not sure if she actually sounds like
she
that.
She sounds like that.
If you're listening, I don't know if you sound like that. I don't think you do.
And she does. I think she does.
So in your inner ear, that's what it sounds like when your mom speaks to you.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. But that's funny. That's one thing, though. Jennifer actually returned to her roots, as a child or young person, where you learned how to sew and everything, and now you've sewn your curtains, you've sewn my pants, it's
well, and
really
I have
cool.
that interest. So now I have that interest in taking that a step further. I've done a lot, we've done a lot of interior decor, decorating exterior work. I mean, everything from removing toilets to changing out ceiling fans, painting like crazy, okay? A lot of painting. But you've done some really hard, like fascia, siding, tough stuff. Roof pieces.
Cleaning out the workshop.
Was
That's what I did this week.
Project.
Yeah.
Yeah, cleaning and organizing is always a part of something.
So if.
But remember that in the, what we put in there, what is that called again? That material that we put in the greenhouse?
Oh, back there, the polycarbonate.
Polycarbonate.
Yeah.
We put in a wall.
Yeah, we tore down a wall.
Yes.
Because right now, well, the stables area, the one big building there, what we did is, since there was no natural light coming in, we decided to take down one wall and replace it with polycarbonate. So it's a polycarbonate wall, so you can see through. It lets the light in, and it was really good for the plants.
Well, and not only that, but we fixed the fireplace, too. You did most of it.
Oh,
all
that wood stove, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
I refurbished
the wood stove.
Not a fireplace.
Yeah.
Bad choice of words.
That's okay.
But how amazing.
That is kind of cool.
Yes. And then we did a lot of antique furniture. So those cultivators.
The old antique wagon. Yeah,
so those things were all refurbished because we wanted to bring them back.
Yeah.
We wanted to kind of make them return back to their former glory, we called
it. And today we had, we celebrated the last day of Sukkot, the eighth day of Sukkot.
Yes.
And we were out there on the back porch, and that's what we use for our sukkah, sort of.
Yes.
And we were eating lunch that was really good.
Oh, you made the most fantastic salmon.
Grilled salmon.
Oh, you guys, it was
asparagus.
Like butter. It was so
delicious, right?
And the skin, you guys, was crunchy. I ate all the skin.
Oh my
God. It was so fantastic.
So, when it comes to refurbishing things and whatnot, there was one project that we actually worked on together, but kind of separate. It was kind of strange. We took the old Amish looking wheelbarrow and we took it apart. Jennifer actually took most of it apart while we were filming. And I took some of the wood from that and made this like little neat box with a couple bell jars in there, and I put flowers in them today.
Oh,
and that was like a lovely piece.
It's
like
a really rustic, almost like a little garden, carrying basket, almost like a wooden basket with this nice nautical rope, guys.
Yeah, she tied
the
rope.
Super rustic there. With some iron work. So
iron work
nice,
that she bent.
We call it,
you
we
bent
call
the
it
rods.
Industrial. It's got some industrial.
Yeah, definitely industrial. It's really
accents.
Nice. Yeah, and I took the bell jars and I shot them with some chalk paint, which
oh,
looks really
yes.
good.
Oh, yes. And it's like this turquoise and then white.
Yeah.
So you have this rustic wood, this iron work, this like wonderful industrial ironwork accents, and then this gorgeous colors.
Yeah, it
looks
beautiful. Draw
you in, and it matches the table and the chairs.
Oh, it's beautiful.
And it was just so fun.
And I walked around, and I just picked some flowers that were out here in the yard.
Yeah.
And
we
it
had
was
honeysuckle,
nice.
and we had crepe myrtle.
Yeah.
And I don't know what the purple ones are, but they are gorgeous, too.
Right.
So we had a bunch of beautiful flowers.
So that was like our centerpiece for our table.
Yeah.
And we had this really cool tree that lights up.
Oh, I love the camo tree. Yeah, it's almost like white birch camo. I love that one. Yeah.
It's beautiful.
We have a video of that one, too. That's a product review.
It's one of our product reviews, right?
Yes. That's all for this time of year, guys, you have to check that tree out.
Yeah, you do.
It is like the perfect white birch. It's like a lit tree. But it's so neat because it's festive.
It is festive. It's great for what we use it for. We have it in the living room most of the time. And it just gives you this nice atmosphere, just relaxed. It's beautiful.
Yes. Looking, you know? And it's like this birch, beautiful. Yeah. Like it goes with any like blue candles, a menorah. It goes so nice.
Yeah, so that's what we did on our eighth day of Sukkot celebration. Woo-hoo! It was really cool. And getting back to the refurbished type stuff, that box that we both made, we put our efforts into it. It was beautiful, and it really set the mood, and we had a great time.
Yes. So, you guys, we encourage y'all to kind of get back to those things. Get back to family time. Get back to, you know, sitting around and just talking about your day.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, and like, you know, if you celebrate the Sabbath each and every week, that's a great time to do it, to have your family time, you know, kick back, relax, watch some movies together. On Saturday, just, you know, spend time together, eat together, play some board games together, watch some good preaching.
And make some popcorn. Get the old, popcorn popper.
She loves popcorn.
And put, you know, melt some butter.
What is that that preaching that you watch every Saturday morning that you have on? I think it's on.
Oh, I like this one.
And on the Hebraic Roots Network.
Oh, you guys have to watch this one. They don't have hardly anybody watching them, but
these guys
I
are good.
Really like them.
If you want some good preaching, I'm telling you, this is making it
right
here.
It's very light, like it's not. I just love they have the most wonderful dancing and music, and they blow the shofars.
Yes.
Oh, it's so neat. I'm looking for it now,
guys. You haven't lived until you heard the shofar.
It's called the Hebraic, it's all one word, Hebraic Roots Network. So it's Hebraic Roots and Network, and it's all one word.
And is that a specific
and
pastor?
It's this, yes. I always watch for there's a River of Life. And like
River of Life.
Yes, there River of Life. So this one, this most recent one was, and it'll come on for a second. You guys might hear this, but maybe not.
Yeah.
But River it was called Looking to His Story for Direction. It's 1 hour and 17 minutes.
Yeah, so you guys want to check that out if you get a chance, because that's some good preaching there. Also, we on the Sabbath, especially on Friday night, we start watching A Rood Awakening. Michael Rood has some great content on his channel. As a matter of fact, they have like 24/7 like live TV or whatever.
Oh, yes.
Which is really cool.
Yes.
So 24/7, A Rood Awakening, go to their YouTube channel. Or I think you can go to arootawakening.tv or something like that on your internet. So yes, great teachings on there. You'll learn a lot.
Yes.
That's important. You know, a lot of people say, oh, I'm more into just a relationship instead of learning. Well, I think your learning helps with your relationship.
I think there's room for both.
Yeah. It's like, I want to have a relationship with Jenny, but I don't want to learn anything about her. That would be silly. That would be dumb.
Yeah.
You know, it doesn't make
sense.
It
wouldn't be very effective.
No. So, yeah, it helps with your relationship. So, with that being said, we appreciate you guys for stopping in each and every week and each and every day.
Yes, and you guys have to tune in next time.
Yes, tune in next week.
For Chapter 4, It's the Heart of a Homesteader. Ooh. And it's one of my favorite verses to start off with. For I know the purposes which I am purposing for you, declares Jehovah. Purposes of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. Jeremiah 29:11.
Wow. That's amazing. And don't forget, we've got a lot of great bands that are sharing their music with us here on Inspirational Waves Indie Rock Radio. Hit those guys up on Spotify. Buy their music. Do all those great things. So, with that being said, we appreciate you guys.
We love y'all so much.
Yeah, and we appreciate you coming, just listening to us and hanging out.
We hope what we said inspired you guys too. So
enjoy your eighth day of Sukkot. Have a blessed one. And we'll see you later.
Shabbat shalom.